This video explains how to interpret deviations from a uniform intensity by hypothesizing whether classification errors in the maps could explain the deviations. This video is the second of a three-part series supported by Clark University and the National Science Foundation. First, we explain the motivation to express deviation in terms of hypothetical map errors. Second, we explain the interpretation of hypothetical errors for the interval, category, and transition levels of intensity analysis. We will continue to use the study area from video 1 to explain the concepts. In part 1, we investigated land change in the Plum Island ecosystems, which is one of several sites in the National Science Foundation's long-term ecological research network. We evaluated land change based on the comparison between maps at multiple time points. Intensity analysis was used to make statements about the change according to the available data. However, the previous video assumed the data were correct. We suspect all maps have error. Such errors could account for some of the difference between the consecutive time points. Scientists can better understand the results of intensity analysis if they were to know the sizes and types of errors that could explain the deviations from the uniform change intensity. For example, the non-gray pixels in the maps of losses and gains represent change during each time interval. We suspect that error exists in these maps, but we do not know how much error exists. Our goal is to compute the sizes and types of errors that could explain the deviations from uniform change intensity for each time interval. This figure shows the annual land change in percent of the domain for each time interval. The 1971 to 1985 time interval has slow change, and the two latter intervals have fast change with respect to the annual change uniform change. Our questions are, how much error in the map of change would it take to explain each interval's deviation from the uniform line? And how does understanding classification error influence how one interprets results of intensity analysis? To answer these questions, we compute the minimum hypothetical error that could account for each deviation between an observed change intensity and the corresponding uniform intensity. We explain two types of possible errors, omission error and commission error. The black box represents our study extent. The yellow circle is forest according to ground information. The green oval is forest according to the map. There are parts of the map that are not classified correctly. The yellow part outlined in red represents the omission error of forest, and the green part outlined in red represents the commission error of forest. The middle section is the agreement of forest between the ground information and the map. From this example, we can draw principles for an arbitrary category, J. Omission error of category J means the ground information shows category J, but the map does not. Commission error of category J means the map shows category J, but the ground information does not. We will now turn to an example from our study area. This figure shows the interval level changes for three time intervals. At the interval level, we focus on the deviation between the observed annual change and the uniform annual change. We hypothesize that each interval changes with a uniform intensity. Next, we hypothesize that errors concerning change explain the deviations from the uniform line. The hypothetical error can account for the difference between the uniform intensity and the observed intensity. The right side of the chart shows the intensity of changes for each time interval. We can see that annual change is fast during 1981 to 1985 and 1991 to 1999, and is slow during 1971 to 1985. The left side of the figure shows the hypothetical errors that could explain the observed deviations from the uniform line. Commission of change errors could explain fast intervals because the maps of change apparently show more change than the uniform intensity implies. Omission errors could explain slow intervals because the map of change shows less change than the uniform intensity implies. On the left side of this figure, the union of the black and gray segments are change according to the maps. The pink segment shows omission of change error, and the gray segment shows commission of change errors. This color scheme holds for all the figures in this video. At the category level, we focus on the deviation from the uniform line for the gain and loss of each category. This figure shows the category level gains for the interval between 1991 and 1999. At the category level, we focus on the regions where the pair of maps show apparent change. We hypothesize that each category changes with the same uniform intensity. Next, we hypothesize that classification errors within the region, change region, can explain the deviations from the uniform line. The hypothetical errors account for the difference between the uniform intensity and the observed intensity. The right side of this chart shows the intensity of gains for each category. Active categories extend to the right of the uniform line, while dormant categories are to the left of the uniform line. We can see that built is an active category and all other categories are dormant. The left side of the figure shows the hypothetical error that could explain the category's observed deviation from the uniform line. Commission error at 1999 could explain active categories, meaning the map of 1999 might show more than the correct amount of the category. For example, if there were 2,144 pixels of commission error of built at 1999, then those erroneous pixels could explain why built's gain appears active. Omission errors of 1999 could explain dormant categories, meaning the map of 1999 might show less than the correct amount of the category. For example, if there were 1,366 pixels of omission error of forest at 1999, then those same erroneous pixels could explain why forest's gain appears dormant. We compute the minimum overall error that could account for all deviations. Each pixel of error is simultaneously commission of an active category and omission of a dormant category. Thus, the sum of all commission errors equals the sum of all omission errors. Analysis of losses is similar to this analysis of gains. However, analysis of losses assumes errors in the map at the initial time point, while analysis of gains assumes errors in the map at the latter time point of the interval. This figure shows the transition level intensity analysis for transitions to built from the losing categories. We focus within the region where built gains. Next, we hypothesize that errors in classification of the losing categories at the interval's initial time point can explain the deviations from the uniform line. The right side of the figure shows the intensity of transitions for each losing category. Transitions that target extend to the right of the uniform line, while transitions that avoid are to the left of the uniform line. We can see that built targets other and avoids both wet and forest. The left side of the figure shows the hypothetical error in each category at 1991 that could explain the observed deviations from the uniform line. For transitions that target, we hypothesize that there is commission error in the losing category at 1991 within the region where built gains. For example, built's targeting of other could be due to the map of 1991 showing more than the correct amount of other. For transitions that avoid, we hypothesize that there is omission error in the losing category at 1991 within the region where built gains. For example, built's gain apparently avoids forest. but this could be due to the map of 1991 showing less than the correct amount of forest. All pixels of error are simultaneously commission of a targeted category and omission of an avoided category within the region of built gain. Some researchers ask, how large must a deviation from uniform be in order to qualify as significant? The word significant has a precise meaning in inferential statistics. Significant means that variation due to random sampling cannot account for the observed deviation from the null hypothesis. However, the examples in our video analyze the entire population of pixels and do not involve sampling. Thus, we do not use inferential statistics. Therefore, we do not use the words significant and insignificant. Other researchers might rephrase the question to ask, how large must a deviation from uniform be in order to qualify as important? The answer obviously depends on the definition of important. Researchers should define important based on the purpose of their research. For our analysis, we focus on whether we suspect the data are sufficiently correct to justify a conclusion that an observed intensity is different than the uniform intensity. For example, look at the tiny deviation between the uniform intensity and the observed intensity for forest. If our data were perfectly correct, then the claim is justified that the gain of built avoids forest. Our method shows that omission error of forest in 35 pixels at 1991 could account for forest's deviation from uniform. If the actual omission error were less than 35 pixels, then there is justification for the conclusion that gain of built avoids forest. Alas, we do not know the actual number and types of errors. However, if we suspect that more than 35 pixels of error, then there is not justification for the claim that the gain of built targets forest. From this video, we learned how errors in the data might account for deviations between observed intensities and the uniform intensity. We showed the sizes and types of errors that could explain deviations from uniform intensities at all three levels of intensity analysis. For more information, read this article by Odwyk and Pontius. You could also go to this website for more information and software to perform the analysis with your own data. You can go to the same website to request more papers concerning land change science. For part 1 and 3 of this video, go to this website for more information. If you have any more questions, please contact Professor Pontius.